Okay, it's recording. So I'm currently lying on my couch and I decided that it would be fun for me to hop on here and make a video about a story that pretty much changed my life, kind of, and like, and how I see dating and like all that stuff. So get some snacks, get popcorn, get comfortable like I am right now, and get ready to hear the story, because this is kind of a juicy story. Perfect. Okay. Let me just put it right here. Okay. Hold on, let me get comfortable, because this is a juicy story. This is actually a juicy story. Also, the intro and the banner thing was made by YouTube Squad Fan. So make sure to follow them on Instagram. They make edits for the YouTube squad and me. She has made a lot of YouTube. She has made a lot of edits for me. And she's my first fan account. So thank you. Love you. But anyway, that's so weird to say that I have a fan account. But anyways, let's get on with this story. So I have an African bracelet. Pretty sure I got it in New York. It's pretty cool, but yeah, I just thought you guys should know that. But anyways, okay, so one time I was at theater and there was this girl that I liked, and our dads happened to work together, and I really liked her, and she really liked me, you know, like, everyone knew, like, we were, like, cool, we were, like, figuring out, you know, like, we were just, like, yeah, because this wasn't that long ago, this was, like, last year, but, like, this is, like, 2018, like, start 2019, like, I was, like, desperate, wanting a girlfriend, wanting a boyfriend, and, like, just, like, you know, just, like, wanting to be in love, and because like all my friends were in love. Like, I was a kid at the school dances that like I would have no one to dance with, and I would just be like dancing with myself at this love dances, and it was really sad, but like, yeah. And I would just like, I just want to find someone, like, I just want to be with someone, I just want to be happy. And me and my friends made this joke that she had big watermelons. You'll understand if you have that mindset, which nobody should, but it's just, we were in seventh grade, and we were just dumb, and we made the joke in social studies class. She didn't even go to my school, but like, yeah. But I'm about to get to the juicy part. You don't want my mom to hear me. This, I think she hates this story. Love you, Mom. Anyway, like I was saying, hold on. So like I was saying, I probably wasn't making any sense because I wasn't having like full on thoughts. But anyway, so yeah. Anyways, oh my gosh. So yeah. My dad got invited to this barbecue. We all got invited to this barbecue. I was excited. I'm like, I'm going to see her again. Yes, yes, yes. And I wanted to, like, kiss her and, like, stuff like that. Because I was still, like, I'm still, like, the same age I was then. Like, I was, like, I just want to, like, get it done. People my age starting to do that stuff, so I just want to get it done. I was kind of like peer pressure, like I wanted to get it done for myself, and I wanted to get it done because I feel like I had to. So I went to her room. Her sister and her shared a room, and yeah, and she went on her bed, and I told her, I'm like, I want to kiss you, and like all office staff, and like, I like she already knew my phone's for each other. We already said that we were a couple, but like, obviously, like, we didn't do anything. We just like held hands, and cause we're awkward teenagers. Like every couple at this age is awkward. But yeah, especially in all the relationships that I've had, which are not really relationships, they're just like little, like they're just like little like. We think they're relationships, but they're really not. So I really have never had a relationship because all of them usually ended. We're too young. We're not experienced. We don't know what we're doing, and we're still growing up, and we're coming of age, and we just don't know what we're doing. So, yeah. And no kissing happened. But, we're lying in the same bed. I kid you not, watching the kissing booth. And her dad caught us. And you know why? Because we were staying in a room the whole night. And I was like, I should probably tell my mom, like, what's going on. So she's not worried about me. Because, you know, my mom gets worried. And I have, like, a tight relationship with my mom. Like, I love my mom so much. Like, I tell her everything. Sometimes that backfires. But anyways, yeah, I told her. And I, like, whispered it in her ear. He was sitting right there. Comes in the room, points to his daughter, and is like, and she gets in trouble, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, just like, what is this, like, this was the first time, nothing's, I haven't, like, I've barely seen her since then, like, I see her sometimes, but, yeah, that was my first experience, and I definitely don't want to, like, do that again, like, if it happens, it happens, but, like, I'm not really looking for anyone. I'm still young. I'm just 14 years old, about to be 15 in September. And I'm just gonna work on me and becoming a better person. And yeah. Maybe in like a few years or something. I don't know. But I'm not worried about that anymore. I'm just worried I'm working on me and becoming more religious and becoming a better person. And yeah. So that was my crazy story. Thank you. That was it, I guess. So, roll the intro. I'm so amazing to love.